to die. Drowned at the bottom of the ocean.
Oh. Alright. Loading the stream. Wait, where's my Twitch? Oops, I'm trying to type on the wrong keyboard. There we are. Oh, I've got to get rid of the Disco Elysium app. Alright guys, just ignore the Disco Elysium app to the right side of the video window. We are actually back for some more SnowRunner. And I am going to... So I was thinking about maybe doing an exploration of Smithfield Dam and collecting some of these watchtowers. But first, I think I might do this Fallen Rock mission, which I don't think I did on my previous run through here, did I? Does anyone remember? So I'm just gonna hang here, check out this task. Got another rock slide that's putting a highway out of action. Can you get a shipment over there and help get it cleared out? And what is the shipment? Rock on activated. Oh, they need two service spare parts. Oh, there's lots of those where I tipped over the freaking trailer before. That is still annoying me. Yo, what's up, Bum Fluff? So I was just having a look through my games list on Steam earlier and found that Clay is now releasing a new game called Rotwood, which is currently having a beta test or something. So I signed up for the beta. I was thinking I might do a quick run of that later after we've done some Subnautica, so we can showcase a new game. I played a game of Disco Elysium earlier today, which seemed to be pretty fun and made me think I should do more RPGs. I've got Pillars of Eternity that I've thought about putting on a video, but it's just a really long game that's going to take a long time to complete, so didn't know if I wanted to commit to it or not. So I need to get service spare parts. Where am I going to get those? Oops. I have to go back to Black River. I went wasting time loading Black River. Wait, where am I going? Crap, I'm going to the wrong place. Why I always use markers and opted not to use the markers that time. This is what happens. You don't set the GPS. Also, am I in a good position on the screen? Yes. Top left has no important information in it. Still annoyed that I lost that I flipped that trailer last week. Every time. Gotta bring two service spare parts over here. Whoa, 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 too fast. Traveling too fast there. Oh, I thought that puddle was going to be deeper than that. Yes, it's what piqued my interest. The fantastic gaming company Clay which brought us awesome games of Don't Starve, and that was how I got introduced to them. And then Oxygen Unincluded, which is a bloody brilliant, if not terrifying and extremely complicated, colony management sim. Our playthrough of Oxygen Not Included hasn't become too complex so far, but trust me guys, it will. It's a really difficult game once you start getting into the end of it. That's fuel. That's the flipped over trailer that I can't use. With a grayed out something. 5 slots maybe. Here's a trailer. Oh, and it's got 1 service spare parts, but I don't want one, I need 2. We're going to go for this trailer. So I'm going to grab this trailer, then where can I get spare parts from? My goodness, no. You're not. I have to go all the way over here? That's so far away. Holy cow, it's going to be a massive drive. What does this have in it? One steel beam. Can't use that. Is the flatbed trailer okay? Or is it too big? Yes. It's an American Truck Simulator length mission. There must be a closer service spare parts in Smithfield Dam. Anyway, we haven't uncovered it yet, so let's just do it here. Grab that trailer. Start getting some bigger, better trucks. Like, am I still just in the early learning phases of this game? I feel like I've been playing it for ages. Admittedly, it's the second playthrough, so that's part of it. But, like, I completed the first map. Shouldn't I get something cool for that? Or do I have to play the non-hard mode? Don't lose money for damaging your truck. Well, you lose money, but it doesn't cost you that much. Not as much as in... Oops. Hard mode. Should probably move myself on the... Oh, I didn't turn my light on. Telegraph pole. Speaking of damaging your engine, that's what not to do. Oh, you can't see the light behind me. I just moved my head in front of it. I don't know why there's a roadblock there. Obviously just going to use the road anyway. Is it just so that normal people don't go there, maybe? Just go back to third person mode just to make sure I don't hit that fire hydrant. Okay, so this is where the trailer is. Oh, no. That's not a fun trailer. I don't want that trailer. Too huge. Didn't I have a sideboard trailer somewhere? Scout flatbed. R- cramped flatbed. Hell no. Oh, here. Anything on it? No. Okay, that's all we're gonna get. I should change off hard mode so that I can actually get somewhere in the teching of this game. Because I'm getting no money doing hard mode. And look, I just smashed up the front left of my truck there, so I've got to spend some money to repair that now. Okay, here's the next flatbed. To go from here all the way across the map. Nope, that's not where we're going. There. There. Nope, we can go on this highway. Stop there to fuel. I mean, I pretty much know where this place is, right? I've done that trek so much. So if it's going to give me missions which stretch across two maps, can I then set waypoints that go from one map to the next map? Oh, hello everyone, welcome, thank you for coming. Well, we've got a couple more viewers in. Don't forget, on this channel, backseating is encouraged. So if you feel the need to do some backseating, you go for gold. I'm actually thinking about playing a game on the channel called The Whispered World, just because like I've got the whole series of games from the developer of The Whisper World. I've got like five of their games. Even more if I include Blackguards, which is another party-based RPG, which is a little bit different to Whispered World. That's a point-and-click adventure. But yeah, I was thinking of starting off playing The Whispered World, which is a point-and-click adventure, and then I was like, if I have backseating in that game, is that going to make it good or bad? If I let the viewers tell me how to finish the puzzles, is it going to ruin the experience for everyone, or are we just going to enjoy it together as a group? Just see that. I almost rolled the bloody thing. Going too fast down that hill. Seeing you guys chatting, am I? There it is. Whoa. Yes, I missed Bumfast last chat that said that would be entertaining. That's what we're all here for, isn't it? To have some entertainment. I know texting and driving is unsafe, but what about reading the text and then just verbally responding to texts? Is that dangerous? Like, am I driving dangerously by reading chat while trundling along through muddy roads? Possibly, because I did just crash into a traffic pole, telegraph pole. Gonna fill up the fuel tank here, even though we didn't use too much fuel in that drive. So from the heavy fuel tanker to the fleet stop. 1,700 liters of fuel left in that. Skills here. Skills of crashing into a telegraph pole. Crossing the river again where it's really boggy for another two times. I wonder how many more times Roger Wilco can cross the rocky bridge here. I'm digging a bit of a rut into this road, look at it. But we can use our skills in diff locking. Easier than usual. Fluff says sink or swim. Hopefully we're going to swim and not sink into the mud. I mean, I know that river's not too deep, and actually with diff lock it works pretty easily. Normally that takes a lot more wiggling when I wasn't even using diff lock on it. So maybe I wouldn't have torn the mud up so much if I was using diff lock the whole time appropriately. Oxygen not included 2019. Hot lava 2019. That did hot lava? Griftlands? What's Griftlands? Is that like a... What's Griftlands? I know the name and I know it was something about you're a wanderer in a desert post-apocalyptic world. I think it was a party squad-based shooter. Dread Pilots? that diff lock makes such a difference. I'll have to look up Dread Pilots. Now I'm going to do some texting and driving. Anyone heard of Dread Pilots? What's it about? Does it have any pictures on it? My phone's trying to look for Dress Pilots. Oh, it doesn't look like there's much information out on it. RP Grifflands is a roguelike deck builder, that's right. And with RPG story elements in a sci-fi setting. Well, I've got Darkest Dungeon, which is kind of... Is that a deck builder or is that just a squad-based dungeon crawler? That's just a squad-based dungeon crawler. I've got Hand of Fate though. That's a deck building game. Alright, we need 2 lots of spare parts, service parts. I wish I took the big trailer around to the service spare parts first. And then brought it back for that mission where we tipped it. Gonna set up my waypoints. Oops. Let me bring this one to here. Or just add a new one, sure. Nope, we don't want to go that way. What is it making a new why? Down the highway. Thing you couldn't do in SnowRunner is put this many waypoints down. Man, oh, I just got it. Just got that waypoint. Oh, ow. That position was not comfortable. Myself across this mud pit. If you guys have any ideas for what I should spend the money on, you can let me know in the comments and I can make my way to a garage and see what we've got available to spend on. Because at the moment I haven't spent any money, I don't think, because I'm not sure what's worthwhile. Do you think I should upgrade my tyres to just one level up, or do we need to get that snorkel for the truck? What do you think? I can turn default off now. Whoops. A new truck, Bum Fluff. Oh, we definitely don't have enough money for a new truck. But I can save up for it. That's basically what I'm doing. Aren't you gonna miss this workhorse? Blank what truck it's called. What's it called? The Star? Can't remember. Oh, that's painful on my brain. Fleet Star. Here we're back at the river. Set ourselves into diff lock mode. Get out and check out the damage. How well this thing can get through. I love the stars in the SnowRunner and MudRunner games. Everything is about the stars. Are we through now? Or did I prematurely turn diff lock off? Did everyone see the new decal on my truck? I got an Orc Warhammer 40k decal. It's out of the list of stuff you can get from the workshop at your base. Factory settings. Menu items that you've got available. I also added the little mud runner tire in the bottom of the window. That's all I did with decoration. I didn't like any of the color schemes. All-wheel drive off, thank you. Good saving of fuel if you turn your all-wheel drive off. Diff lock can use up even more fuel on top of the all-wheel drive fuel that's used up. Just gonna swing in here and grab the fuel. Woof. That was about as much fuel used up on the way over as on the way back. Slow down, trailer. Don't go over the edge. Okay, there we go. Now we're en route for Smithfield Dam. passed around that corner. How's the mic sounding, Bumfuff? You said it was cutting out earlier. Is it still doing the cutting out on the stream, or is it okay? It must have just been the way that I was talking. I know the sound quality isn't as good as the HyperX, but I'm finding it really difficult to find a cord that does a conversion from a USB Type-A plug to a USB Mini. I think it's a USB Mini that I need. Into Officeworks, and neither of those places can sell me the cord that I need. Because I think that the problem with the microphone might be just that the little plug that goes into it broke off some of the teeth that meet up, because it seems to be a bit loose in there. So that's the only thing I can try. Yeah, J-Car. Specialty store for cords. Cables. We were rocketing through town with a full load on our trailer. Oh, it's just driving through town with it on all-wheel drive mode. Wasted fuel. Too shabby driving across the dirt there. Turn it off all-wheel drive. And back on. I drove past J-Car Audio the other day and I was like, oh, I need to go in there and get a cord, but stuff she needed to get done, so we didn't have time to drop in there. Next time. Until then, you're gonna have to put up with the crappy noise, background noise on this microphone. Not sure if you can hear the background noise in the stream, but you can hear it in the post recording on YouTube. Alright, here we go. So basically we just need to get this up this hill on this nice easy road and then deliver it to here. Easy. Easy mission. Side there. Oh, careful there. Lack of concentration will get you killed on the road. I need some water. There is the open road. Well, you know what I didn't do was fill up my fuel. Should I take this trailer back and fill it up? Yeah. Am I going to be able to back the trailer up into that? Let's see. Oops. I jackknifed it. No, I'm just going to refuel. I'm not taking it with me. Am I? Your Iron Man is empty? Yes, my Iron Man is empty of water. Bumfluff says. There's a trailer here. What is this trailer? I can't see it. Oh, it's not a trailer. It's a shipping container. Alright. Hydrate! Okay, you asked for it. I gotta go get some water. To appease the masses. Oops. So just before I go on with that mission, I'll be back in a sec. I just need to get water. I'm back. Oh yes, I did forget to leave my turn my engine off. And I remembered to put my microphone down. You know what? Should I bring my petrol trailer down here? Not up into there, obviously, but this way. Because I do need to bring it with me to get across there. There's no... There's no... watch out, see, I can't get that one. I might be able to get across this bit, but it looks a bit scary. I got this watchtower. Yeah, so I think I should bring the fuel trailer down with me. Complete. Oh, I just smashed a fuel tank. That was quite a bit of damage too. This is why we have no money to buy a car. The other way. I thought that trailer was the other way around. Which trailer is this one? Is this the missing... No, this is my fuel tanker trailer, isn't it? Can't remember. Where is that mission? The missing fuel tank? It doesn't show you the tasks from the other map. See that? Did you see that? Pro. Not so pro on the way out, but reversing in, came as close as I could to that pole without hitting it. Fluff has tagged me as pro gamer. Only if I can get 1,000 subscribers on YouTube and I start getting paid, then I'm a pro gamer. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Should I try it in low gear? Am I stuck on something? Or is it just... I must have been stuck on a rock. See the rocks on my way up. Oh, careful, that one almost damaged me. Here it is. What part have we found? Oh, there's a smashed up car here. The AAT6V44. Not available for current truck, a thoroughly reworked variant of an outdated engine. Increased power output at the cost of reliability. Physical damage tends to make it lose power and consume more fuel much sooner. Such items. I wonder what truck that goes. Show truck list. Available for the Scout 800 and the Chevy 6K CK1500. There you go. Fluff says, I just flew out to get iron ore and flew back once I was full inventory, and the smelter is still cooking the last batch. Must need a second smelter. Time to expand the operation. Oh, get out. Two engine damage. Oh, ouch! That's how I died in Ark earlier, going too fast down the hill. No. I wasn't even going fast that time. Oh, good idea, I have one here already idle. Oh, nice. Repressed memories. Alright, so we just did... the mission. We just did the repair mission. We just found the what are they called? Upgrade. Let's go up and see what this hungry workers mission is before we move forward on this map. Dust yourself off, pick yourself up and go, yeah, sure. When you have after a sleep before you throw your computer out the window. I remember back in the day, we were playing probably a Super Nintendo game or something. Couldn't get the mission to work. Couldn't finish the level. It was being really annoying and tricky. And then Mum said, "Okay, just go to bed. It's bedtime now." And the next day, when we woke up, finished the level really easily. My mom was like, yeah, you just needed to have a break. Get away from it for a bit. Allow your brain to unwind from the gaming and then come back. Have another go. Good advice? I'll let you decide. We're heading up this waterlogged road to see what this mission entails. Probably gonna have to grab food from somewhere, maybe the farm. Nothing to see outside. Too dark. Dust yourself off and try again. Dust yourself off and try again. If at first you don't succeed, if at first you don't succeed, dust yourself off and try again. If I'm singing the song, does that get me a warning for a copyright? Apparently, Dyson Diesel Management has prioritized materials and equipment deliveries above food and water. The workers are living off basic rations and morale is not looking good. Can you pick up the slack? What does it need? Hungry workers. Dust yourself up and try again, try again. If at first you don't succeed. Show task. What? It doesn't tell me what I need to bring. Here. Two consumables off. Oh, I have to take it to the drilling site. Well. Anyway, we're gonna go down here, I think. Oh no, there's no road there, so we're gonna try and go down here maybe. Let's see where that road goes. Doesn't even look like a road, it looks like grass. Driving through someone's backyard. Alright, Plum Fluff says his second furnace is cooking. Grats. Gonna be pumping out, gonna be drowning in metal bars soon. In arc up on Twitch for us to be able to see, Bumpuff, so we can see what you're up to over there. Learn a lot about your pro arc playing. Okay, oh yeah, I remember this bridge. I've lost a car to this bridge before. Flipped it over. Ah! Not quite F, but nearly. Oh, we got a new mission. Well, well, well. So, new nest. It wouldn't be too bad here if I don't flip over. Because it's... Uh-oh. Last words. Oh. Just hanging there with all my wheels off the ground. As long as you don't flip over going across there, the pit's not too big. But going across the bridge, if your wheels go off and you roll it, I think it was in the Scout, you know, the top heavy Scout F800 or whatever it is. I flipped it over. And it's very easy to flip over. Much nicer to bring the Chevy. The Chevy has a better stability. Alright, so we just uncovered this. Oh, the farm had a mission as well. Wait, what? Ah, I take the consumables from here and then drive them to here. Oh, there's an upgrade there. And a well. Wow, there's so much to do. But we're almost at the end of our episode here, guys. I'm gonna go down and check out what this threatening accident mission is. And wait. Should I move the fuel tank? My fuel trailer is here. I wonder if I should move it to here. Yep. Time flies when you're having fun. I'm gonna move this fuel tank forward a bit. Probably to around here somewhere, just before this bridge. Maybe at the threatening accident. So just put in some markers there so I don't get lost going around here. Because it's dark, I might not be able to see what I'm doing. And go to here. Icarus. The non-stop animals is actually my own doing, because I played the mission on hard mode, which increases their chance of spawning aggressive creatures. Stop damaging my fuel tanks. How am I damaging my fuel tank there? Turn, mate, turn. I've lost a quarter health on fuel tanks and a quarter health on engine. I think it starts leaking fuel at half health on the engine. Come on. Nice road. Oof, that is such a massive dip. that fuel tank nearly didn't clear it. Alright, so we're gonna head back down to here now. Oh, this is where I want to go. Threatening accident. Yep. Just gonna move the fuel tank forward a tiny bit. Just to be a little bit more central. And a little bit more out of the way too. Like off the road. Not that it matters because I'm the only truck driving around here. Game enough to drive on these muddy roads. And eke out a pay of basically nothing. Earning just enough money to repair your truck. Okay, so I'm gonna leave the fuel trailer here. Has the whole town gone loony? A driver managed to drop a whole cargo of fuel into the river. I've since fired him, but I've got a bunch of barrels floating around the river that need hauling out. Well, we don't have the equipment for that mission yet. Threatening accident. Because then, if I can do that, I've also got two other things that are floating around that need picking up. Where is that mission's... Nope. Threatening accident. Oh, really? It doesn't tell you exactly where they are? It looks like it could be one there. And there's one there. The others could be anywhere in the darkness. I've got to go get this watchtower. Take it back to the fuel station, is it? Yeah, you need truck with crane for that one. Anyway, that will be for a future episode. Thank you very much for watching, guys. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to like and subscribe. We'll catch you in the next one. Bye for now.